It's 2019 and we're still debating over the no headphone jack issue, which is an issue. What's up YouTube, it's your boy BMAC. And it is time for an old-fashioned BMAC rant on this channel, something I have not done in a long time. Ooh, this is gonna be fun. So I've been on Twitter a lot lately, and one of the things I've been seeing with all these new smartphone releases that seem to be happening on a daily basis is the fact that people are still upset over there being no headphone jacks in these new smartphones. And here's the thing. When Apple first got rid of the headphone jack in the iPhone 7 back in, what was that, 2016? I understood people's frustration. Even I was frustrated to a degree. People don't like change. People don't want to have to adapt if they don't need to. But I think people are forgetting we had then and we have now completely viable alternatives to the old school headphone jack. And perhaps even more importantly, I think people are forgetting the reason why we're getting these smartphones with no more headphone jacks anymore. Simply put, there are basically two reasons why. One, better technology. Wired headphones, wired anything really, are becoming a thing of the past. I mean, why even bother with this mess of cords and cables if we have an easy to use and simple wireless alternative? But reason number two, which is kind of a lot more important than reason number one, is space. Headphone jacks take up a lot of space, both externally and internally, with our smartphones. With the powerhouse hardware that we're getting in these smartphones these days, I think it makes sense to kind of ditch the old technology in order to make room, literally, make room for the better technology, more powerful technology. We are literally making room for the new, more powerful tech by ditching the old, outdated tech. But that's really as simple as it is. Those two main reasons are the reasons why we're phasing out the headphone jack, whether you agree with them or not. But what kind of irks me is the fact that if you disagree with the no headphone jack movement, the fact that you still don't quite understand that we're not just left in the dust, we have alternatives. For those of you who are stubborn and refuse to adapt to the headphone jack-free life that we're living, let's break this down so that hopefully by the end of this video, you can understand why no headphone jack isn't necessarily such a bad thing. Let's put it this way. The reasons why you want a headphone jack is so that you could either listen to music or talk on the phone. And we'll usually do that in one of three different situations. With headphones or earbuds, in the car, or when using a speaker. So with headphones and earbuds, how exactly does someone go about using those headphones and earbuds without a headphone jack? Well, for starters, most smartphones have a compatible dongle. Like this little dude, right here. This is a dongle. This is a 3.5 millimeter audio jack to lightning adapter. And this little thing right here is realistically the only thing you need to use any pair of wired headphones with your iPhone. Other smartphones have other dongles, but when this thing first came out, I gotta admit, I was kinda pissed off at the thing. But again, that's because I wasn't fully adapted into the wireless lifestyle and things were still kinda new living life without a headphone jack. So now, even though I'm rarely using this, it's nice to know that it's included in the iPhone and that your other smartphone devices probably have a dongle as well, so that it's there when you need to use it. And if that's not good enough, there's like a 99.9% chance that your smartphone manufacturer has headphones available directly compatible with your smartphone device. Kinda like this pair of headphones that came with my iPhone. As you can see, there's no dongle here whatsoever. Instead of the 3.5 millimeter audio jack, we just have a lightning connector at the end there. So I just plug this in directly into my phone. It's basically the same thing as an audio jack. But perhaps the best way to adapt to the headphone jack-free lifestyle is using some of these. Or some of these. These are wireless Bluetooth earbuds or wireless Bluetooth headphones. Now these things have come a long way since 2016 when the headphone jack was first killed by Apple. They instantly connect to your iPhone. You can listen to your music within seconds. All without wires, all without having to use a headphone jack. And it's probably the best and intended way to live without a headphone jack. Now, should you have to go out and purchase wireless Bluetooth earpods or headphones? No, you shouldn't have to, but again, you don't have to. That's what the other options we just talked about are for. Now, another quick little note to argue here. I know some people say they want a headphone jack so they can still deal with wires, and that way they don't have to worry about batteries. But the batteries in these things are pretty impressive, especially taking into consideration how great they sound, how portable they are, and how long they last right now as it is. These Apple AirPods, for example, will last you 3 hours talking or 5 hours listening on just one charge with the AirPods themselves, not even taking into consideration the multiple charges that the case itself holds, and the 2 hours of talk time and 3 hours of listening time you get with these things with just a 15-minute charge. And then we could talk about my Beats Studio Wireless. These things last for about 12 hours, give or take. I use these mostly for when I'm at the gym. I think I have to charge them once every
like 2 weeks.
They last a very long time, so in my opinion, batteries aren't really an issue when it comes to these wireless earbuds and wireless headphones. Is there room for improvement? Sure, there's always room for improvement when it comes to battery life. But I think battery life right now isn't really a major issue. I love these things, and I promise you, if you pick up a pair of wireless earbuds or wireless headphones, you will instantly see how helpful they actually are to your daily lifestyle. Once you go wireless with a pair of wireless earbuds or headphones, it's very hard to go back, and you'll see why the headphone jack is kind of overrated. If you don't believe me, try them out for a few weeks, then come back and talk to me. But what if we're in the car? A little bit different situation here. You could still use a dongle in case you want to convert your auxiliary cord in your car to a compatible cord that you could use with your smartphone. You could even purchase like 6-foot cords online, with one end being the 3.5 millimeter audio jack and the other end being that native port for your smartphone. Those are pretty cheap. But nowadays, you could even purchase a Bluetooth receiver that you just plug right into the audio jack of your car. You could get them for like less than 20 bucks on Amazon, and they instantly convert your car into a Bluetooth ready system. Getting Bluetooth in your car for less than 20 bucks, not too bad if you ask me. I did that for years in my Pontiac before I upgraded and got a new Wrangler last summer, and I never had a problem using that Bluetooth receiver in my Pontiac for the several years that I used it. And lastly, I know there are situations in which you wish you could, say that one 10 times fast. I know there are situations in which you wish you could use your smartphone with just a regular speaker system. Nowadays, we have super powerful, super portable, pretty loud Bluetooth wireless speakers. Just like the wireless earpods, you turn these things on, they're already connected to your device. Within seconds, you have a portable speaker that's loud, sounds good, and again, allows you to play music on a speaker without having to actually plug it in via a headphone jack. And these things last a long time too. I don't have any battery issues with this. This is the Ultimate Ears Wonder Boom. This thing is so loud, it bumps. Me and my friends actually got kicked out of a vineyard for blasting music too loud on this thing, but that's a story for another time. But hopefully this helps you understand why the headphone jack really isn't that necessary anymore. By removing some old school tech to make way for some new school tech, and with the cheap, simple, and easy to use alternatives, I am all for killing off the headphone jack entirely. I'm not gonna miss it, especially with these backup options we have. Hashtag RIP headphone jack. I'm gonna miss you for nostalgic reasons, but when it comes to technology, there's really no reason for it anymore. So having said that, I'm gonna go untangle these things so I could use them in the gym. Haha, just kidding. I don't use wired headphones anymore. I'm on that wireless cable-free life, baby. Come on. I will see you guys in my next video. I do wonder what to do with all these old cables and cords, though. Maybe knit myself a scarf? That'd be pretty cool.